Day six in the Smokies. I've been feeling something coming on since Gatlinburg. I'm pretty sure I got the norovirus. You haven't lived until you've taken an emergency explosion in the middle of the night in the Smokies during a thunderstorm with no shoes on because you didn't have time to put them on. Only in your underwear in the rain. It was kind of a long night. and now I'm sleeping in and just letting it go away, I guess. I don't know. It's only, fortunately, like a 6 mile day today. So I got the time to try and heal up a little bit, I guess. Yeah.
I've been really pretty careful about, like, norovirus and stuff. I surprisingly feel like I've been one of the cleaner ones on the trail as I see people. Like, I always use my hand sanitizer sensible, appropriate times, often multiple times a day. I brush my teeth. I go the extra mile, put in the extra effort to go, you know, a little further or harder for the water. Choose my water sources wisely. I don't know that I got norovirus. I think I got Golden Corral Buffet virus. That's what I got. That makes sense, and the timing works up right, because the next day when I grabbed some Subway, I only had a 6-inch. It was like the only thing I had had since then, and I didn't even finish the damn thing. So I think I got Golden Corral Buffet virus. Buyer beware.
Really thankful that I downloaded a bunch of shows. Well, really a whole bunch of episodes of one show. I downloaded like all 5 seasons of Fringe. This is a really cool show. It's right up my alley. So I'm sitting here binging those.
Alright, it's like 4 o'clock or 4:30. I finally got up. Got my bear bag down, and since I keep my toiletries inside of the bear bag, again, anything with a smell, my medications that I brought were in my toiletry bag. Seemed like a logical place for them, but it's not, because then they're up in a tree when you need them. So I'll be moving those. Fortunately, I have some anti-diarrhea in there. And so I got up and found the privy. And it's not raining at the moment, so that's a nice change. And I had a cup of coffee.
That's it though.
Right. I'm fine with it. I think I'm gonna just fast this thing out for the next 24 to 36 hours and just do water fast. And I have a couple, like, I was gifted some trail magic of effervescent like vegetable pills. I've never seen them before, but kind of cool. I'm probably just gonna do that, whatever liquid based things. What else here? Thank God for good tents. I'm really, really, really happy with this Nemo Hornet tent here. And I got the 2-person. And you know, let me give you a tour. So there's doors on either side of the tent, which is pretty nice. So it doesn't matter which direction you set up. I'm kind of in a really small type spot right now, as are a lot of the spots along the AT, I guess, so far. On the side with that I'm using as the door, I use the pocket here for my defense tools, I guess. So I got my bear spray and knife, stuff like that. And then on the other side, I'll do my gadgets and stuff and cords and cables and things that need to be recharged. I put my bag here on the side that I get in and out at, and my backpack, and then my sleeping bag, which is, you know, the air mattress and cover here on the far side. And let's see, up top I have my Bluetooth speaker and my headlamp up here, so I can have a little bit of ceiling light. And yeah, over here, I use my seating pad, and I'll put my battery charger and plug in everything that I need. I can prop it up here, watch a show, or look at the maps for tomorrow or whatever. So that's about it for the luxurious tent tour. I think I will. Well, it's getting dark already, suddenly. And so maybe rain is coming back. In that case, I'm just gonna stay here. I don't know. We'll see. Push on, stay or go. It's about 6 miles by the time you leave this shelter, which is half a mile off the trail. I don't know.